I have actually been meaning to address this for a while. I just haven't had the opportunity to. Well, I've had the opportunity to, but I haven't had like the mental capacity to. But now I think it makes sense to address it. I did have a few of you message me privately after Greta died, which is fine. It's so nice. But a few of you did message me and said that you had Highlands too, or Longhorns, and you were curious about what happened because you didn't want to make the same mistake or for the same issue to happen or whatever. I answered a couple of you, but then I just didn't have the energy until now. I wanted to actually write it out or put in a video. That's what I'm going to do right now really quick. But as you saw, or you've seen, the feeder we used, have been using, is a typical tombstone feeder, which before we got our Highlands, I researched and found that most people that I knew with Highlands recommended tombstone feeders because it's rounded and they can get their horns in between and it's safe and whatever. What happened with Greta was not, I didn't see it, but I'm pretty confident with how it went down, pretty sure, because I saw her after. So I saw the final positions, you could say. We had just got a new bale delivered.
Hi, Brady.
And I think we had someone eating from the one side, and then Greta was eating from the bottom of the bale, of the new bale, on the one other side. And you know how bales work. They're like literally layers, swirly whirly field Twinkies.
Bernie, leave it!
Hey, it's flakes off in layers, right?
Birdie! Leave it!
Birdie! Leave it!
Toddlers, right? What I think happened was whomever was eating from the opposite side chewed down to like the first flake layer, and it like released following. So there's like the Twinkie, and the first cow on the other side chewed down the first layer, which for whatever reason released the other side of the flake. If that makes any sense, it does to me. I don't know if I'm explaining it properly, probably not, because I'm calling it a Twinkie. Anyway, I think someone was eating here, through the layer, flake released, and while Greta had her head under here, I think that flake was weighty enough that it collapsed on her. And while I don't think that alone would have caused what happened, I think she got spooed because she was so low down that she probably started panicking and thrashing, and then her horn, I think, got stuck in the bale. Well, it was, because that's where it was in the hay when we found her. I think her right horn got stuck in the bale, and the more she fought, the more she got stuck. And then she just probably, she grew tired. She like relaxed herself, which unfortunately, I don't know the term, but where the tombstone meets the rim of the feeder, that's where her neck was. I think the weight of it pushed her head down over that and basically just like choked her out. I don't think it was the type of feeder. I think it's literally just a freak accident. The new feeder we got is a tombstone as well. We got a wider width between them because that's better. Gives them a little more room. But also my girls do just fine with the one that we have. They figured it out. Anyone who was worried about that, I don't think it's something you can prevent. I really don't. It was freaky and it was really shitty. So apologies for the delay in explaining that or answering that question. I hope that helps. All you Highland or Longhorn owners that messaged me, just, you're doing a great job. And what happened to me was, I don't know what the percentage or the statistic of that happening is / was. So don't worry, carry on, and hopefully nothing like this has to happen to you. Anyway, I see you in the reflection, you goof.
It was a serious moment. It was a serious moment.
Stay.